Great. So today we are going to talk about workflow rules. So what is workflow rule? Workflow rule is, initiating some action automatically. So rather than manual intervention, when I say action, what action are we talking about? There are a few actions which can be initiated automatically without manual interference. Okay. So let's say, you want an automated email to be sent to the client on certain, when certain criteria is met. That criteria can be anything. Or let's say whenever there is an order which has been taken and quantity in the order mentioned is more than a certain amount, you want to send an automated email to the production manager. So that sort of things where there is a criteria, and the moment the criteria is met in the data, you want an action to happen. Something similar to validation rule. In validation, what we were doing, we defined a criteria, and if that criteria is met, it should not allow the record to be created. We wanted the system to restrict the record creation if the criteria is met. In workflow rule, we do not want to restrict the creation of the data. We want the system to create the data but follow that with some action, maybe sending an email or something like that, right? So that is it. So workflow rule is very simple. What we do here, we take an object. In workflow rules, we take the object, we define criteria, and we define action. So for which object you want to define the workflow rule, what will be the criteria, and what will be the action. So that is what we define here. That's our workflow rule. So let's take this example, a simple example where we talk about. Which object were we talking about? Okay. Let's say I want to define a rule where in case there is a product and the price of the product is listed more than $300. Okay, for example, if any time a product is entered into the system with a price more than $300, you want to send an email to the owner of the product. Fine. Let's say this is the criteria that you want to work on. Fine. So there, in that case, object is product, criteria is price greater than 300, and action is sending an email. Simply, so that is a workflow. So this criteria could have been anything. You can pick any object, and action you can define. So there are a few actions which can be defined. Correct. So that is how it works. Let's go and define a workflow rule for this. The price of the product is So this is what we want. Okay, this is the requirement. Business logic is this. How will we achieve this? We will achieve it through workflow rule. So let us go and create this workflow rule. Set up. Create. Come to workflow and approvals. Click on workflow rules. Click on continue. Just skip this step. New rule. So a new rule we have to define. So I will just tell you about how to come to this screen again. Go to setup, create, workflow and approvals. Click on workflow rules. Go and click on new rule. Select the object. Which object you want to select for this? Product is the object, right? No, which product? So give a name to the workflow rule, that's fine, I mean that is what we do. Okay, this is where we have to define the criteria. So we have selected the product, we have to define the criteria. So the criteria, there are two criteria here. One is the rule criteria, one is the evaluation criteria. Okay, so rule criteria is simple. When the price of a product is more than $300, that is my rule criteria. Okay, that is the rule. So let me just go and define the criteria here. It's pretty simple. Let's go and define the criteria. Okay. Sorry. We need to take the other product, not that one. So this is one standard object called product. So it got connected to that one. We need to connect it to the custom object that we created here. See, product price greater than 300, so this is our workflow. Now evaluation criteria. Rule criteria we have defined. What is evaluation criteria? When you want this rule to be evaluated, the rule that you have defined here, when do you want this to be evaluated, that you have to define, right? So do you want the rule to be evaluated only when a record is being created, or you want the rule to be evaluated when it is being edited also as well, right? So in case you just want the rule to be evaluated at the time of record being created, then you should select the first one. In case you want the rule to be evaluated every time it's being edited. Every time being edited means no matter what is being edited on that